OpenAI just make the deep research available to the ChatGPT Plus plan. And so even if you don't subscribe to the premium $200 plan, you can still enjoy 10 deep research queries every month. And I believe this limit will keep increasing. So in this video, I want to share 5 amazing ChatGPT deep research workflows that you can use for work. No matter if you're a marketer like me, product manager, analyst, you will benefit from these workflows and turn hours and hours of work into minutes. Let's go. To initiate a deep research, just simply click the deep research icon to turn it on. And note, it will show you how many deep research queries are left, and it will reset every 30 days from the date of your first usage. And it will always ask clarifying questions before it starts the deep research process, and only one complete deep research report will be counted as one usage. So my tip is to use it to refine your research directions, as I found the question I always thought though, so you can further enhance the context. An important thing is that the research areas that you mentioned in prompt will significantly impact how long your final deep research report is. So if you haven't specified a word count, it will very likely cause report truncation. That means the report output will be cut off as it reached the output context window limit, and the time of generating the full report will be much higher. For a case I tried where I haven't specified the output length, it took around 40 minutes to complete the full report with over 16,000 words, but the report output has been cut off, as it tends to expand each section with so many words. And also, I always suggest you do fact-checking and never take whatever it gives you. Even as a premium deep research like this, it will still hallucinate. Okay, our first workflow is to build what I call an intelligence database. If you are a product marketer, analyst, or business strategist, you know how painful it is to collect different data, summarize, and structure them. But now with OpenAI Deep Research, we can shorten this 30 hours plus process into just an hour of setup and review. So for example, I'm a product manager looking to build SEO software targeting B2B customers. And so I want to find everything about the top market players in this field. Now let's pick ChatGPT 4.0, turn on deep research, and use this prompt to ask it to create a detailed competitive analysis for the top 5 SEO software, including funding, history, tech stack, product features, pricing, etc. Note, I have explicitly mentioned this report should be within 5,000 words to ensure it won't cut off the output. Then it will ask more clarifying questions. So answer the question and we can click start. So now you can see it start compiling the sources, and it usually takes at least 10 to 15 minutes depending on the depth of research you request. Then after 12 minutes, the report is ready. It's used a total 42 sources, and I can see most of them are SEO vendors' official website, Wikipedia, TechCrunch, and the content is really detailed, starting from SEMrush on covering the areas I specify. And what I really like is when you click those with data claims, most of the time it will highlight them exactly where they mention in sources. And the report also include a feature comparison table, which is super cool. And finally, with the conclusion. So this is fantastic. Of course, always do fact checking with your own judgment. Now to build a database, we need to first ask it to extract the insights and format it into a table with our specified columns. But since you can see the attribute values are not standardized, so let's use this prompt to further enhance it a bit with our specified attribute values. So this is much better, and then export and download it as a CSV file. And now to build this database with dynamic view in a centralized workspace, we will import it to Notion or Airtable, which support importing with CSV. For example, on Notion, I have created this space about SEO competitive analysis. Then on this page, type /CSV. This will prompt you to import a CSV file. Select the CSV file we just export. Then immediately it will pull everything and set up the database. And we can modify some of the column properties to be multi-select. So now you can see everything is so organized and clean. And it would be very helpful for you to keep track insightful data that you get from deep research. And I would say not only for competitor info, but perhaps pricing info, features info, customer pain points info, and you can keep updating this database. And you can even publish and share it with your stakeholders or teammates. And so whenever you have new data, you can also use the merge with CSV function to append the new data. The next, research your presentation. So typically for most of us, we need to build presentation decks, but using deep research, it can save you so much more time where typically you might need. And together with AI presentation tools, we can shorten the whole process even more. So this is a powerful workflow whenever you need to build quick presentations from research, for your stakeholders or clients. For example, I am doing research about the technology trends for the financial service industry. So again, turn on deep research and use this prompt to ask it to research for the latest digital transformation trend for this industry. Answer all the clarifying questions. So it starts researching, and after 12 minutes, a report is ready and is used 33 sources. It looks very comprehensive, covering three core subtopics I mentioned: AI in financial service with the current trends and outlook, and a summary table of use cases. Then talks about blockchain and cloud, and we can randomly check the sources. It's using the big consulting and media websites, and I like how they highlight the exact quotes for your reference. This is what I'm not seeing from other deep research tools. Now to build the presentation deck, we have two options. So first is to ask it to create an executive presentation in PowerPoint format that highlights the key insights. Then you can download it, but it will only contain the key points without any design. But it's still a good starting point if you prefer customizing yourself. Another option is actually to use Gamma AI, which is an AI presentation tool that quickly turns your sources into ready-to-use slides. So first, we copy the whole response as we are going to use it to build the deck. Now go to Gamma AI, click Create New. So there are different options to import sources. We will pick Paste in Text, then paste all the response and select Presentation. Then you can further edit the prompt for the configuration. Let's click Continue and keep all the default settings. And here we can choose the theme and style for the presentation. Let's just pick one and click Generate. And so within a minute, the presentation is ready. Gamma will automatically structure and format all the deep research report into a beautiful presentation. And it looks pretty decent with images, diagrams, and every element is adjustable and is ready to present. If you want, you can also export it to different formats like PDF or PowerPoints for further changes. So it's super handy to quickly turn your research report into a deck. And I would say this is a good choice if you just want to make some beautiful slides really quick using publicly available data and don't need lots of customization. All right, the next one, strategic decision making. The true value of doing deep research is to get insight faster to inform the decision making. So deep research is always just the first step. What we need is how we can use it to make better decisions. And so rather than stopping at the deep research, we can combine with the reasoning models for useful strategy recommendations. And I will also show you bonus how to one click to organize all these insights into Notion. For example, I'm part of an international business team and I am evaluating potential expansion into the new international market, Malaysia, for the healthcare tech market. And we need some comprehensive research analysis. So turn on deep research and use this prompt to ask it to research the healthcare tech market for Malaysia, including market size, growth rates, key market players, regulations we need to consider. I always like these clarifying questions because they're thoughtful, like asking about what kind of customers and time frame. And now let's start researching. So this time it takes 8 minutes and use 20 sources. Looking at the sources, most of them are consulting data, government or research websites. So it covered lots of key information, the market growth with a summary table breakdown by different submarket segments, which is helpful. It also details the key market player with details, key regulations for considerations, and very important, what are the barriers we should take note. Now let's say this is our healthcare tech brand to enter this market. And here is the basic company information. I just pulled it from Perplexity, but if you have the public company annual report, I suggest you can use it as well. Then in the same chat, turn on the reasoning model. Let's use O3 Mini as it's the latest version and use this prompt to ask it to base on this deep research and the company information and to recommend the market entry strategy and suggest how to adapt the business offering for this market. So this is one of my favorite workflows to use deep research as you are combining everything and leverage these models' intelligence to come up with suggestions that you might have missed. And then after some thoughts, it will give you the strategy suggestions and with rationale and the biggest risk that we should consider, so you will get more directions on how to fine-tune the strategy. And I highly suggest you ask more follow-up questions and give it some more important context information, and I guarantee the suggestions will be much more quality and meaningful. Now we're not done yet. A bonus is you can save these reports and insights to Notion with just one click. So we can download this free Chrome plugin, Chat to Notion, to save any response to Notion, even for deep research. I learned this plugin from my other creator, QQ, so credits all go to him. So once you install, you can select the page for access permission. For demo purpose, I've already created this database, Core Market Research Analysis. So go back to the chat, click on the plugin, and you can save the full chat and watch the magic happen. So what I really like is that it will save everything, including the prompt you have used, the full deep research report. Although some formatting for the citation might have lost, it doesn't have any huge impact. And even the chain of thought process from the reasoning models is saved as well. So this is so useful whenever you have done the deep research and find something insightful that you don't want to lose, and you can save it to your repository and keep it organized. So if you're a Notion fan like me, make sure you tried it. The next one is knowledge visualization. Everyone loves Noble LLM, and I found its new mind map feature just make learning even more intuitive and engaging. So combining with ChatGPT deep research, you can literally research on any new subject you want to learn about and turn it into amazing knowledge visualization within seconds. For example, I'm a complete beginner of UX design and I want to upskill myself in UX for more career growth opportunities, and then turn on deep research, use this prompt to ask it to research everything about UX design, including core principles, fundamental concepts, key methodologies, learning resources, and the essential UX tools. Then answer the clarifying questions like what's the specific goal behind the learning, resources to focus on, and start the research. Now I see it's compiling sources from different authorities website around UX design, which is good. Like UX Design Institute, Design Lab is covering everything that we need about the subject. And I like how it breaks down different core subjects. And I also particularly like the resource sections that it outlines the tools, recommended courses, bootcamps, books, communities, and even comes up with career tips in UX design. Now we can copy the full response and on Notebook LM create a new notebook for this learning project. Let's say UX design learning, and then paste the deep research response through the paste text import option. And of course, you can always import other sources related to this subject. I also got another video about how you can find quality learning resources and import them on Notebook LM. I will put the link below. And now click mind map and it will generate the visual mind map in seconds. And immediately you can quickly visualize the core concept relationships and hierarchies, and you can expand all the notes to understand the key subtopic underneath. And to further explore, just click the note and it will initiate a new prompt in the chat about the subtopic, and it will summarize the key knowledge gathered from the deep research report, which is super helpful because it makes the learning much more intuitive, more organized using the mind map view, more interactive and engaging. And you can even export the mind map to an image for future reference. Okay, the next one, and you will love it, is interactive customer or audience simulator workflow. One of the best use cases of deep research is to do audience research faster. So whether you are a product marketer, product manager, or UX designer, you will get so many insights very quickly. And the best part is we can actually build a custom GPT to test your design and marketing messaging using the research. And let me show you how. For example, I'm the marketer for a home interior design service brand, and I am doing audience research about my target customers who are homeowners or residential clients. So on ChatGPT, turn on deep research and use this prompt to ask it to find how real customers talk about home interior design service and search for reviews and comments across platforms like Reddit, X, Quora, and home improvement communities, and include the direct quotes from real customers. And again, I like the thoughtful question about the target market and prioritize customer segment and type of discussion. Answer all of them and start the research. Now I can see it's following the instruction to look through discussion on Reddit and also community sites like House. Finally, it's using 50 sources, but I can see that Quora is missing and mostly it is using Reddit. And so this is something to take note. And looking at the report, it summarizes the key pain points, the language they use to describe the problems, and with the direct quotes where you can click on it and further check. And it also summarizes the key decision-making factors like budget, desire for personal involvement, trust, timeline. So these are all useful insights to guide your messaging or service package. I think the only complaint is that it used too many Reddit sources, that the insight might be a bit bias, so you might want to do a second research but focus on other type of sources. Now copy this response and save it as a Word document or PDF file as we're going to use it to build our custom GPT. Now on ChatGPT, click the Explore GPTs and click Create as we will build a new custom GPT. So you can either use the prompt create options or configure it directly yourself, but I prefer using the prompt option as the experience is more intuitive. Now attach the audience research report we just did and use this prompt to mimic how our target customers speak and make decisions about home interior design service, and make sure the feedback is based on the report insight. Then it is configuring and asking about GPT name and the product image, click yes and proceeding. And within a minute, this real home client simulator is ready to deploy. And note, we're still in the preview mode, but we can start using it. So we can start by asking any question. Let's say this is our existing homepage, and we can ask it to give honest feedback about it by giving the link. So you can see the response is hilarious. It's trying to mimic the tone learned from the insights. As it says, the first impression is that the design is very outdated, and which I agree is not modern enough. And what I like is give me possible questions that my target audience or customers might have when landing on this homepage. Like, am I going to get something special? Will they get more style? And then what makes this so useful is that we can ask it how to improve from the perspective of these customers, like showing the real work, adding some personality, which I strongly agree for interior design service. So this is very handy whenever you want to test your messaging, ideas, packages, asking for feedback. If you think it's ready, you can click the create to publish it and click only me, then it's ready for your usage anytime. And whenever you have new research, you can always click edit GPT and upload any new knowledge about your target customers or audience so the response will be more accurate. All right, make sure you try all these use cases to save time for work. Would you make any enhancement to make them even better? Let me know in the comments so we can learn from each other. And if you want some more inspiration and stay in the loop, you can join my community. You can find the link in the description. And before you go, also watch this video about using Perplexity and NopoLM for research workflow if you're a big fan of NopoLM like me. I will see you next time.